Hey guys, it's Amy Nicole, and I'm bringing you the best Town Hall 13 hits from competitive play this week. Alright, so the first hit that I'm going to show you today actually came from a Pinnacle Cup war between Tribe Gaming and Noble Nines. Now everybody knows who Tribe Gaming is. Noble Nines is actually one of the clans that was a finalist in the ESL North American Mobile Open, and they competed in Atlanta against One Hive. So a very, very strong team. The first hit that I am going to show is actually a Tribe hit from Lexnos, came in on Ange's base. It was a Mass Hog. A very strong hit here. Was very fun to watch live, so we're gonna go ahead and show this off. Now, Lexnos is a content creator. He recently got started streaming, and he was streaming while he was doing this hit, so that takes an extra step of talent, I want to point out. I have a hard time enough hitting, let alone streaming and hitting at the same time, so kudos to Lexnos for sure. First thing he does here is he sends in that blimp and gets a rage down as well. It's gonna take out that Inferno Tower, clear out that entire compartment, and it's gonna pull the CC as well. He gets the queen, the fancy queen as I call her, the Mulan queen, placed down at the 12 o'clock area. We're going to see the healers drop with her in just a moment as well. Ice Golems are making their way up to that direction. Now he does hold on to the poison. I think the queen goes through three freeze cycles, if I'm not mistaken, obviously with the three golems up there. And then the king comes in around the 2 o'clock area. I think he waits for her to get frozen all three times before he drops that king. No, I'm mistaken. So king's coming in, and then he's sending in the wall breakers. And what he's gonna do here is actually a double layer wall break. So he sends in the first test wall breaker. He does trigger the skelly trap. So the skellies are going after the king. The king is setting the funnel here. Now this takes a lot of talent. And we know Tribe is the best of the best, and he did a really good job. So he goes in and gets the rage down for the queen. We're going to see that second layer of wall breakers sneak in there in just a moment. Waiting for her to get down that town hall, and then sure enough, there they go to cut in. When she has access in this compartment, she's going to be able to reach through and take care of the enemy queen, the enemy royal champ, and then she's going to be able to cut in and get through to that eagle. So he starts his hog run over here near the 3 o'clock side, sends in his royal champ there as well, and then of course the warden close behind. So queen is going to work her way through that wall, trying to get in for that eagle. Now he does find the Tesla farm down here near 6 o'clock. He gets a little bit of a split out of the hogs, and what you're going to see here is a really good freeze. The reason it's a really good freeze is that's going to allow those hogs to pick through to get to that expo. Did just enough damage for the royal champ to get through and allows the rest of the hogs to split and take care of the rest of those defenses there as well. Queen still has her ability in play, as you'll notice, but plenty of hogs left, plenty of cleanup left, and still holding onto that poison, didn't have to use it. So a really strong hit. There was plenty of time left on the board. He did a really fantastic job getting this done, and he goes ahead and swags that poison there at the end. So really good job to Lex. Again, streaming while hitting. I don't know how you do it. Tell me your secrets. All right, so the next hit that we're going to watch actually came from the next Pinnacle Cup War of the day, which was between Noble Nines and Activity, another competitive esports clan. This hit came in from Boom of Noble Nines, and it was a P.E.K.K.A. Bobat, but we're going to go ahead and watch this one. Zoom out here a little bit. So he started off with the king up at the 1 o'clock area. We have the P.E.K.K.A.s on the opposite side at 11, and the wall wrecker and queen split right in between. Already has a little bit of wizards down for the outside building cleanup. What he's trying to do here is set that funnel to get right into the core of the base, which he does pretty successfully. Drops the rest of the P.E.K.K.A.s and bowlers and gets those healers in there as well. They end up all meeting up together as they should as he pushes into the core here. Now, King does press his way outside to 3 o'clock. We are pulling the CC at this point as well, and then the Eagle does go down. He is sending in his warden a little late. It does go a little rogue. Heads out towards that cannon over near 10 o'clock-ish, I guess we'll call that, but it does hop back inside to meet up with the troops eventually. At this point, everything is starting to push into the core of the base, taking care of the town hall. And then he's trickling in those hogs that he had in the pocket over near 9 o'clock. Does run into some Teslas, triggers some skelly traps as well, but the Royal Champ helps kind of pick up some of all that stuff over there. We're seeing the rest of the Teslas being triggered, and then he sends in that Bat Wave. Now, the good thing about that Bat Wave is there's no more splash damage left except for the Wizard Tower that we're looking at over at 3 o'clock. So these bats are able to take out the majority of the defenses that were left on this base. You'll see that there are not a lot of troops left up, and especially once we clear through all of this, really the only thing that was left was the Royal Champion, and she was trying her best to pick through those bats. Uses that free spell over the Wizard Tower, they get that down nice and easy, goes ahead and drops the second one, probably didn't even really need that. But as you see, the next 30 seconds are spent with the bats trying to pick off those buildings on the outside. We've got the Queen and the Warden meeting up, trying to take care of the Royal Champ, and it's just going to be the rest of the base to be cleaned up. So, did a really good job with that one. Again, the bats just sweeping, like, pretty much half the side of the base there at the end. So, really good job there. Really good hit from Boone. Boom, sorry. Peckabo Bat still works, guys. It's still a thing. Good job. The last hit that I'm going to show you guys today was actually an air hit, and it was one of the few that we saw from the Pinnacle Cup matches today. It was iPro coming in on Boom, so let me go ahead and get this one started for us. It was a Lalo, a Sui Lalo. So started off down here, just using a bowler bounce to try to pick off that mortar, and then goes ahead and drops the King. So really working to funnel off those two sides, you're going to see the wall breakers start to head in now, and they're going to try to break open that compartment to allow Queen access. Has to go ahead and get that freeze down to allow them to sneak in. So a really good funnel was set there. This is going to allow Queen access to take down that Inferno Tower, grab a couple other defenses, and then we're going to set the Royal Champ over here at 3 o'clock. Goal is for her to grab that air defense. She does find a Tesla. She's able to pick that Tesla off. Goes ahead and pops her ability. Was trying to get her inside of a little bit push further, probably to grab that Eagle. Gets a few shots off, but does not quite get it down. So at this point, going to go ahead and release the air over near the 9 o'clock side. The Eagle is going to kick off and start raining down on these loons. And you guys will see what happens and what adjustments need to be made here. So you'll see we already have those hounds pop. Goes ahead and gets the Stone Slammer dropped up near the 1 o'clock area. So we're pretty much covering this half of the base from the 9 to 12 o'clock side. Warden Tome already used there. Gets a freeze down over that Inferno Tower Expo Scattershot area. This allows those loons to continue their push. Gets a haste down. Trying to get as much down as quickly as possible here at this point. You'll see the Stone Slammer continuing to push through. We've lost all the loons at this point in time. Trickling a couple back end loons, hasting them into the Wizard Tower, Archer Tower. They're able to push through. And as you can see, that Eagle being one of the very last things left up. We do have some air skellies. They're picked off fairly quickly. We do still have the enemy queen up in the core of the base, but she is just hanging on. We already had early cleanup down. And at this point, it came down to just finishing the cleanup and getting the triple. So this was one of the triples that Activity had on the board for their war. This was a really crazy war. This war opened up with Activity getting a 99% 2-star and Noble Nines answering with a 99% 2-star. Activity got a triple the next hit. Noble Nines got a triple the next hit. It was very back and forth for the first half of the war. A really, really good war to watch. That one is on my Twitch. So if you guys don't see it up above, up here, the very first link is for my Twitch, twitch.tv/AmyNicole. You can find the war there if you guys are interested in watching both this one and the one with Tribe Gaming should be there. Guys, thanks so much for watching my first YouTube video as a Supercell content creator. Make sure that you guys use those social media links posted above my head. I've got my Discord and my Twitter up there. I've got some bloopers from this video posted on my Twitter for you guys to watch. And please make sure that you are following me on all those social media links. And make sure you hit that subscribe button here as well so you get notifications when I do go live. That's all I've got for this first video. Again, guys, thanks for watching. I appreciate it. Happy clashing.